How are you guys? Ke feze fela ke yena fela ka ithumbono esithombeni la itse lona ke amapiano o'clock isikhathi samapiano guys. Today's tutorial is inspired by private school piano, the likes of Calvin Momo and etc etc. So let's go through the three progressions that I want to discuss with you guys, and then yeah. Let's start. Progression number one. Let me play progression number one. Utwang fela, ke feze fela. That was progression number one. Now let's go to progression number two. Give is a fail. That was progression number two. It's actually my favorite. So now let's go through the last one, which is progression number three. Okay guys, that was progression number three. So before I go into explaining the progressions, let me just go to the sounds that I used, if you guys maybe will be interested in using them. So for the piano, let's look at this thing. I used Nexus piano, Grand Piano Soft. That's the sound that I used. And then for the layer, I also use Nexus single layer pads. So it's the PD Ambient Pad 3. You can find it on your Nexus VST. So for the horn sound, ta ta ta, let's go through the sound that I used. I used Purity Echo Drops. Guys, Purity is an important VST to have if you want to produce a piano. There are a lot of sounds that are being used in a lot of amapiano songs. So, okay. So now let's go and explain the first progression. I'm going to go chord by chord. Forgive me, guys, if there's a clipping sound that is coming out. Currently, my laptop has a lot of things, so my CPU is a bit overused, but bear with me, guys. So let's go through the first progression. And then let's explain it. So I'll go chord by chord. So this is the first chord. Just minimize this thing a bit. So this is the first chord. The first chord is A flat minor. You can just look at it. A flat minor. The second chord is a B flat major, and then the third chord is B major, and then the third chord is a C sharp major chord, and then the last one is an E flat minor chord. It's an E flat minor chord. So in terms of the numbering system, this is a 2 3 4 5 6 chord progression if you are using the number system. Let's go through the second chord progression. This one is my favorite. It's my favorite. Let's just revile ka yona re utlwe. Yeah, this one is nice, guys. It's nice. It's nice. It's a nice chord progression. So it's simple, really. It's just three chords, and it's in the key of B flat. So the first chord is a D minor chord. We have a D minor chord here, and then the second chord is a C major chord. And then the last one is a G minor chord. It's a G minor chord. Remember, guys, these chords are extended. For example, you have your triads, you have your seven chords, you have your, you know. So these ones are extended. I will ensure that in the next coming tutorials, obviously depending on the reception that I receive from you guys, I will give you the actual chord names. But for now, because I wanted to do a preview and explain to you the thinking process that has worked for me in terms of coming up with these chord progressions. Okay, guys. Now let's go to the last one, the final chord progression. Let's play it. Let's hear how it sounds. Let's just a replay of it. Let's just play it and hear how it sounds. All right. So this one is also not that hard. It's in the key of A flat. So it's a 6-4-5-2 chord progression if you are familiar with the number system. So now let's just go through the chords. Let's just go through the chords quickly there. So the first chord. The first chord is an F minor chord. F minor. Sorry, pardon. The second chord is a C major, C sharp major chord. And then the third chord is an E flat major chord. And then lastly, the last chord is a B flat minor chord. It's a B flat minor chord. So like I explained before, even this progression, it's the same concept really. The chords are a bit off, the velocity is a bit randomized. Obviously, I'm not done mastering these chords. They're just only for the tutorial, but definitely, to give that human feel, like I explained before, you need to try by all means to find things that you can use to give it that element that will tell the listener that whoever played this thing or was a human being, and the playing is authentic. In keyboard terms or piano terms, we have something that we call a touch response. Keyboard players have a different touch response, so this it will give you a different dynamic to your the way you approach Amapiano piano chord progression. Okay, guys, we are done with the tutorial. Thanks a lot for listening, and remember to like and subscribe and look out for new content. There's a lot of content that's coming in. So to close off this tutorial, let me close it off with my favorite chord progression. I hope to see you guys next time. Please do add a few comments there. They keep the channel going. Thank you guys, and yeah, let's continue learning and growing. Ke amapiano ke bafana ba teng a ke re la ba bona next time re tla hlakana lena ke feze fela ga ithu mbone tshombene sharp pafe 2.